parentheses around this binomial, but the parentheses really don't serve any purpose. There's nothing to distribute. Okay? There's just a 1 there. Distributing a 1 is not going to do anything. There's no exponent there. We're not trying to take the square root of it. Nothing's really happening to the parentheses. There's nothing to combine inside the parentheses. So there's just really no point to them being there. If you want, you can think of it as distributing a 1, but what you're going to wind up with is just exactly what you see. What about these parentheses, though? Is there something important about these parentheses?
Yeah. I mean,
what should we do? Well, the negative is at the beginning of the parentheses, outside the parentheses. We really have like a negative 1 out here. Negative 1 times the parentheses. So what do we do with that negative 1?
Distribute it.
Yes.
So we distribute the negative, we get negative 2a squared b. Negative times negative 4b is positive 4b. Negative times positive 19 is negative 19. There we go. Okay, now we're going to see if there's any like terms that we can combine. And if there are, we combine them. If there aren't, then it's just going to stay the way that it is. Here we have 8a squared b's. Is there any other a squared b, a squared times b out there somewhere? There's one, a squared b, a squared times b. So we have 8a squared b minus 2a squared b. How many a squared b is that? 6a squared b. Okay. And no other ones. You got a negative 6a, and there's a, sorry, is that a? Let me see that. A. Negative 6a, there's a 4b, can you put a's and b's together? No, so we got negative 6a plus 4b. They can't be put together, so they just have to stay that way. And this is the only constant, just a number with no variable. If there's nothing for it to go together with, that's it. 6a squared b minus 6a plus 4b minus 19. So distribute the negative. Number 48. Well, n. What does that mean to have an n right next to the parentheses? What's the n doing to the rest of that stuff?
Just one n.
Okay.
Just distribute.
Okay. We would distribute if we saw any, like, multiple terms being added together, subtracted. Do you see any of that inside the parentheses? So there, I mean, I guess we could distribute. We're distributing it to one term, right? So what we have is just n times 2m squared. And if you think about it, 2m squared n, it means 2, right, times 2, times m squared times n, right? When you see numbers and letters written right next to each other, these are being multiplied. Okay. Well, when I'm multiplying a bunch of things together, it doesn't matter what order they're in, so I could write it as 2 times m squared times n times n. I could put this n over here at the end. And what's n times n?
M squared.
N squared. So 2m squared n squared times. The reason I can do this is a little thing called commutativity. We can commute or move this n over here, just like we can move this stuff around. 2 times 3 times 4 is the same as 2 times 4 times 3, which is the same as 3 times 4 times 2. Whatever order I put these in, it's not going to make a different number. Same number every time. 6 times 4, 24. 8 times 3, 24. 12 times 2, 24. So that's why I can take this n and move it over to the other end, because it's all multiplied together. Let's get out a piece of paper then and just take a quick review. All right, one of the things that can cause you to make mistakes is trying to skip steps. Try not to skip steps. First thing we want to do with this negative is what?
Distribute.
distribute it. So we're gonna distribute it to all three of these guys here. So it's gonna leave us with 2x squared plus 3x minus 7. Negative times 4x squared is negative 4x squared. A negative times positive 5x, or sorry, a negative times a negative 5x is a positive 5x. A negative times a negative 9 is a positive 9. That's the step I'm talking about skipping. I mean, if you have a lot of practice, you can probably skip it, turn the negative, turn the 4x into a negative, and then combine it all at once. But if you find yourself making mistakes, then don't skip that step for a while. Practice writing the step out. Now that we have distributed the negative, we're going to combine like terms. We got 2x squared. Look along here for another x squared. There's another one. 2x squared minus 4x squared. Negative 2x squared. 3x plus 5x. Negative 7 plus 9. Take a second and go ahead and distribute the negative and write that step and just write all of your steps down. Okay, ready for the next thing? Here we go. Let's get out our notes. I'll wait for you to get your notes out. Okay, so we have added and subtracted polynomials. Now we'll multiply. We're not going to divide. Okay, not yet at least. So we're just going to multiply. But we've done this before. In order to multiply a polynomial by something, you just need to know the distributive property. Okay? And sometimes you have to do the distributive property multiple times, which we have done. Let's take a simple example. 2x plus 4. Is that a polynomial?
No.
It's a polynomial. It's got many, or multiple, more than one. There it is. It's a binomial. It's got two terms. Now, if I want to multiply this by 5, what's that going to be? When I multiply this by 5, what am I going to get? Distributed by 5. All right, so let's change this 5 out for something else, like a negative 3. Now, what are we going to get when we distribute that negative 3? Negative 6x. Now let me just change it out for something silly. I put a happy face right there. I want to multiply this polynomial by a happy face, which means I have to distribute the happy face. What would that look like? 2 times x times happy face. And? That's 4 happy face. Distributed. We multiply the happy face by everything in the parentheses. I can put anything, and we all agree that I can put anything there, and I would just distribute that thing to each of the terms.
Yes.
Okay. Agreement reached. So if I put parentheses right there, how would I distribute the parentheses? Well, there's nothing there yet. Just like happy face, what would this look like?
2x.
2x times parentheses
plus 4 parentheses.
4 times parentheses. Right? So good. So there's a parentheses, you multiply by the parentheses, we distribute the parentheses into the parentheses. And this is what we wind up with. Each term multiplied by the parentheses. So if inside the parentheses there were some other polynomial like negative 5, that's negative 5x plus 3. Okay. That is the parentheses. That's what's inside the parentheses. It's the same as this parentheses. So that's a negative 5x plus 3. This is a negative 5x plus 3. So far, so good. We just distribute the parentheses to the 2x and to the 4. Now, how do we multiply the 2x by the parentheses with the rest of it?
Oh, God.
multiply the 2x by the parentheses with the red side.
This guy did. Sure did.
Just like we had before. So 2x times negative 5x will be?
Negative 10x squared.
10x squared and 2x times 3.
6x.
And now we move on to plus this stuff, which is 4. We get? Instead of writing plus negative 20x, we write minus 20x.
Plus 12.
Plus 12. Alright. So negative 10x squared plus 6x minus 20x plus 12. We would be done except for what?
You gotta combine my terms.
Yeah, we got some blank terms here in the middle. So negative 10x squared, 6x minus 20x is negative 14x plus 12. Yeah, we did this a little earlier, quite a bit earlier in the year. Multiple distributed multiple times. And if you have several terms in here and several terms in there, most you're just going to have a step where you distribute this parentheses into every term in this parentheses, and another step where you distribute that stuff into the original parentheses, and then we combine that terms.
Would it matter what side you did it, like you did it, you used negative 5x plus 3, and you multiplied 2x and the 4 by each side. Would it matter if you did use the 2x plus 4, you multiplied it by the 5x over 3?
Nope, it would not matter. That would be the same. And it's because that's called basically commutativity. It doesn't matter the order that we multiply it. Let's try another one, showing that we might distribute multiple times, okay? And then that way we can distribute large polynomials into other large polynomials. Let's use a couple of small polynomials again. So we have 3x minus 8, okay? So what I'm going to put here is another polynomial, but keep in mind, that's just something that's going to get distributed into its parentheses. So whatever's in that parentheses is just going to get carried along as a big unit of the parentheses to both of those things, right? So we're going to have 3x parentheses minus 8 parentheses. Whatever's in that parentheses just goes along and just hangs out in the parentheses, whatever it is. Say in the parentheses, it's 4x plus 9. All right. Well, in each of these parentheses is a 4x plus 9. 4x plus 9. Why don't you take it from there, right? Go down and do the work and see. Okay, so we got here two separate distribution problems. We're going to distribute the 3x into the 4x plus 9 and the negative 8 into the 4x plus 9 as well. 3x times 4x will be 12x squared. 3x times 9 is going to be 27x. And then a negative 8 times 4x would be negative 32x. Negative 8 times 9, negative 72. No like terms of 12x squared, so that's just but these two x's, they're both x terms, so they can be combined for a negative 5x and minus the 72, which can't be combined with anything else because there's no other constant terms to combine with it. And we have done double distribution. So as long as there's just two sets of parentheses, no matter how many terms are in there, we're just going to have two distributing steps. And if we're feeling strong about this, like we're distributing correctly each time, we can look at a little bit of a shortcut too. Okay. Let's try and step up the difficulty just one little notch here. Let's say we had x squared minus 3x plus 8. Okay. Let's first.
Are you gonna add another step to it?
No, I guess. Not, I wouldn't call it another step. I would just say another
if you put 2 in this, then it would
So first, let's just distribute an empty set of parentheses and then we'll fill it in. Okay? So this helps cut down on confusion just a little bit. Okay. So let's see what you do when you distribute an empty set of parentheses to these three terms here. Okay. So if we we all agreed beforehand, if we have parentheses like the right set of parentheses, and something multiplied by it, in order to multiply those two together, we distribute. It's the distributive property. Okay, that goes for anything, any number, any happy face, any empty set of parentheses, any full set of parentheses. We just distribute that thing. So here that thing is, right there, it's going to get distributed to those two things. So we have x squared times parentheses minus 3x times parentheses plus 8, what? And parentheses was just an empty set of parentheses, we'd pretty much be done because nothing to do after that. But these parentheses, of course, are going to be filled with polynomials. So let's throw a polynomial in there like negative x plus 2. Well, when I distributed that parentheses, I really distributed the negative x plus 2 as well. Right? Every parentheses has a negative x plus 2 in it. I'm going to let you do this next part on your own. All right, we got distribution here. You got a second distribution here. You got a third distribution here with the 8. That's three separate distributions. Let's do those three distributions. And then, as always, look for common terms, like terms that we can combine. So here we go, distributing. And three, we have three different distribution problems here. So x squared times negative x.
Negative x cubed.
Yeah, positive times negative, negative. X times a third x is x cubed. X squared times 2. 2x squared. All right, next distribution problem here. Negative 3x times negative x. Negative times negative is positive.
Negative 3x squared.
But it's positive.
We're positive.
3x negative, negative 3x squared. Negative 3x times positive 2.
Negative 6x.
All right, second distribution problem is done. Next and last is the 8 being distributed. So 8 times negative x
is negative 8.
8 times
2
is 16. Okay. So you know it's not too surprising that the highest power in this guy here is 2. The highest power here is 1. So the highest power we're going to get is to the third power. And it's not surprising that there's only one of those. It's only going to happen when the x squared gets multiplied by the x, which we have to do. And it's not surprising that the lowest power is 0, right? Or just, it's just a number. Then we're going to have one number here, one constant without an x here. There's only one way that's happening, when the number from this one is multiplied by the number from this one right here. This so those don't have any like terms, but we may have some like terms here in the middle. In fact, there's these guys are like terms, these guys are like terms. We have a negative x cubed, 2x squared plus 3x squared is 5x squared. Negative 6x minus 8x is negative 14x. And then we got that plus 16 there at the end. Alright, so beginning to end, let's make this a 2x squared plus 4x minus 3. We're going to multiply that by this polynomial here, and that'll be a negative 3x plus 2. Okay, so there, I'm just getting you two polynomials. You carry it out all the way from the beginning all the way through the end. Let's see how you do. All Okay, so we're gonna multiply these together the way that we've been doing, distributing, distributing again, and then we're gonna notice something that we've actually, by doing those two distributions in each of the problems that we've done, in the three or four or so that we've done, they all follow a similar pattern. Okay, we'll look at that. But first, here, let's go ahead and color code this. You get the one in black here, and we'll do one in orange. So when we distribute the negative 3x plus 2, this whole thing, just like we distributed in the very beginning of class, we distributed a 5, we distributed a negative, I think negative 3, we distributed a happy face, right? We've been distributing sets of parentheses from then on. Okay. So this set of parentheses gets distributed. It gets distributed to 2x squared, so it looks like this. 2x squared times 3 negative. So we distribute the negative 3x plus 2 to the 4x now. We've done the whole thing to the 2x squared, and now to the 4x, which looks like 4x times. Too clever. Negative 3x plus 2. We distribute it to the negative 3. Negative 3 times. There it is again. Negative 3x plus 2. Then we're going to distribute the 2x squared into this parentheses, 4x into this parentheses, negative 3 into this parentheses. We just have those three distribution problems to do. 2x squared times negative 3x is negative 6x to the what?
Cubed.
To the third. Darn, yes. Cubed to the third, same thing. 2x squared times 2. 2x squared times 2. Is 4x squared. All right, so we distributed, that's one of three. We distributed one of three problems so far. Next one here, 4x distributed into the same parentheses, right? So 4x times negative 3x is negative 12x squared. 4x times 2 is 8x. Last, we have negative 3 times negative 3x, that's a positive 9x. Negative 3 times 2 is a negative 6. Last, we look for common or like terms. This guy doesn't have anything in common with any of the other terms, so it's just all by itself, the only x cubed term. These are both x squareds. Okay. Depending how you do this and what order you choose to do it, whatever your style turns out to be, you may not wind up with the x squareds right next to each other every time. It just depends on how you do this. If you do it this way and everything's written in order, then you probably will. In any case, 4x squared minus 12x squared is negative 8x squared. 8x plus 9x, 17x, and minus 6. That makes sense? Okay, so let's notice something that might help us to cut out an extra step, or, you know, don't cut out the step and make fewer mistakes. When we distribute this thing, right, this whole parentheses, to every single term in this parentheses, and then we, in turn, distribute everything in here into these parentheses. Notice all that really happens. Like if I wanted to cut down on this, make a little shortcut, all I have to do is make sure that, just like in this step, everything in here gets multiplied by everything in here. That's what happens here. Then this thing here, right, this is the next one, it gets multiplied by everything in here as well. That's what happens here. And then this guy, this last guy, has to get multiplied by everything in here. That's what happens in this last step. I don't have to write that second step in order to make sure that happens, right? I just have to make sure every possible pair happens and that pair gets multiplied together. Right? And I can do it in any crazy order I want to just make sure that that happens. Make sure that every pair possible gets multiplied together. So make sure this guy gets multiplied by that, that, and that. Make sure this guy gets multiplied by that, that, and that. And you'll wind up with all this same stuff. So let me show you what that might look like if I didn't write down that step of distributing the parentheses. So if I had 2x squared minus 4x plus 2, and I was going to multiply it by 3x minus 4, right? Just like I said here, and you'll notice, I'll scroll back through the other ones, you'll notice just everything in here, every term in here, gets paired up with every term in here, and they get multiplied together. It happens there, it happens here, everything in here gets multiplied by everything in here. You see every possible combination gets made and multiplied together. Same thing here, everything in each of these two gets multiplied by each of these two. They all get paired up and multiplied together. Same thing here. And I believe that's it. You know? You just have to make sure every pair gets paired and multiplied. So I'll make sure to pair this up with everything in here. Okay, 3x, and I might just draw a little arrow to keep track. 3x times 2x squared is 6x to the third. 3x times negative 4x, negative 12x squared. 3x times 2 plus 6x. Okay, well, 3x just got paired up with everything in there, so I'm sure that's done. Negative 4 needs to get multiplied by everything as well. Negative 8x squared is what we get when we do that. Negative 4 times negative 4x is positive 16x. And negative 4 times positive 2 is negative 8. You'll notice that all this left now is combined like zero. We didn't have to write out all that distribution. But in doing that distribution multiple times in four different examples, we notice that the same terms can be produced by pairing up every possible pairing and multiplying it together. And we combine like terms. Here's a negative 12x squared. Here's a negative 8x squared, so negative 20x squared. Here's a 6x, here's a 16x, so 22x. And minus 8. There's no other constants to put that together with, so that's the only constant. And as long as we make sure that every possible pair gets multiplied, we can multiply together all sorts of craziness. It's going to be x to the fifth minus 4x to the fourth plus 3x cubed minus x squared plus 8. I don't even have room for just an x, but that's fine. This could be negative 3x to the fourth plus 2x to the third minus 8x squared plus x minus 9. And as long as I make sure that every term in here gets paired with every term in here, then I'll be sure that I multiply those two polynomials together correctly, and then I combine like terms. And if you think about it, since everything here needs to get paired with everything in here, this is going to get paired, right? This one guy is going to get paired with how many things over here? How many is that? There's five of them. Okay, so that's five terms. This is going to pair with all five of these as well. That's five more terms. This one's going to pair with all five of these. That's five more terms. This one and this one, they all are going to produce five more terms. So how many terms would you wind up with if you paired everything in here and everything in here? 25. We got this one is going to multiply and make five terms. Five terms when you choose that one. Five terms here, five terms, five terms. 25 terms. Okay? You typically don't multiply things that big until you get to calculus. Nothing to worry about for a little while. Nothing really that big. But we could do it as long as we were really meticulous, careful, and make sure to pair up everything with every other thing.
Wait, is this the next two parentheses?
No.
This is a complete line. Please
excuse the interruption. Boys,
C,
basketball team, will be practicing at 3:30 today.
No,
boys, squad basketball. Practicing at 3:30 today. Thank you.
Sorry, yeah, since as Branson calculated, we would have 25 terms, right? I'm gonna sit here and work through that one. Okay. But if we compare together every pairing and multiply them together, then we have the ability to multiply any two polynomials together, no matter how big or small they might be. So any questions?
I just forgot that I have to go down to Jones to do a report.
iffy as to whether or not I'm gonna, you know, maybe I'll forget to pair up two of these. I want to make sure that I don't miss anything. Okay. The table is just a way to make sure that you don't miss anything. Everything here needs to get multiplied by each thing here. So if in a table, across the top, let's say, if I put every term in its own little column here, -4x, +2, and here, vertically I write 3x and -4, then in each cell of this table, I can make sure that everything is paired up. Like 3x needs to get multiplied by 2x squared, there's my 6x to the third. This needs to get paired up with -4x, -12x squared. 3x times 2, 6x. The table is just a way to keep all of this information straight. Make sure you don't miss anything. Gives you a way to easily check your work if you did make a mistake. Okay, so when it says use the table, that's all it's talking about. If you don't use the table and you just draw little arrows, that's another way to do it. If you distribute the parentheses here to all three of these things, that's another way to help make sure that you keep track of everything, and the table is just another way. So another trick to use if you want. But however you want to find the product,